distinguishing between solutions, true solutions. For the preparation of a true solution of sugar in water, add 10 grams of fine powdered sugar in a 250 ml beaker containing 95 ml distilled water. Then stir the solution using a glass rod until the sugar dissolves. To check the transparency of sugar solution, take some of the sugar solution in a test tube. Paste a small strip of cellophane paper on one side of the test tube and view it from the other side. The cellophane paper is clearly seen from the other side of the test tube. This indicates that a true solution is transparent. Filtration of sugar solution. Place a funnel over a test tube using a clamp stand. Then place a filter paper in the funnel. Now, pour some sugar solution taken in another test tube through the funnel. A clear filtrate is obtained. There is no residue left on the filter paper. This indicates that solid particles cannot be separated from a true solution by filtration. To check the stability of sugar solution, take some sugar solution in a test tube and leave it in a test tube rack for 20 minutes. The solution remains as it is without sediments. This indicates that true solutions are stable and do not show component deposits. For the preparation of a true solution of common salt in water, add 10 grams of fine powdered salt in a 250 ml beaker containing 95 ml distilled water. Then stir the solution using a glass rod until the salt dissolves. To check the transparency of the salt solution, take some salt solution in a test tube. Paste a small strip of cellophane paper on one side of the test tube and view it from the other side. The cellophane paper is clearly seen from the other side of the test tube. This indicates that a true solution is transparent. Filtration of salt solution. Place a funnel over a test tube using a clamp stand. Then place a filter paper in the funnel. Now pour some salt solution taken in another test tube through the funnel. A clear filtrate is obtained. There is no residue left on the filter paper. This indicates that solid particles cannot be separated from a true solution by filtration. To check the stability of salt solution, take some salt solution in a test tube and leave it in the test tube rack for 20 minutes. The salt solution remains as it is without sediments. This indicates that true solutions are stable and do not show component deposits. For the preparation of a true solution of alum in water, add 10 grams of alum in a 250 ml beaker containing 95 ml distilled water. Then stir the solution using a glass rod until the alum dissolves. To check the transparency of alum solution, take some of the alum solution into a test tube. Paste a small strip of cellophane paper on one side of the test tube and view it from the other side. The cellophane paper is clearly seen from the other side of the test tube. This indicates that a true solution is transparent. Filtration of alum solution. Place a funnel over the test tube using a clamp stand. Then place a filter paper in the funnel. Now, pour some alum solution taken in another test tube through the funnel. A clear filtrate is obtained. There is no residue left on the filter paper. This indicates that solid particles cannot be separated from a true solution by filtration. To check the stability of alum solution, take some alum solution in a test tube and leave it in the test tube rack for 20 minutes. The solution remains as it is without sediments. This indicates that true solutions are stable and do not show component deposits. Suspensions. For the preparation of a suspension of soil in water, add 10 grams of fine soil in a 250 ml beaker containing 95 ml distilled water. Then stir the solution using a glass rod. To check the transparency of soil solution, take some of the soil suspension in a test tube. Paste a small strip of cellophane paper on one side of the test tube and view it from the other side. The cellophane paper is not visible from the other side of the test tube. This indicates that a suspension is opaque. Filtration of soil solution. Place a funnel over a test tube using a clamp stand. Then place a filter paper in the funnel. Now, pour the soil suspension taken in another test tube through the funnel. A clear filtrate is obtained. Soil particles are seen on the filter paper. This indicates that suspended components of a suspension can be separated by filtration. To check the stability of soil solution, take some soil suspension in a test tube and leave it in the test tube rack for 20 minutes. You will note a gradual settlement of soil particles at the bottom of the test tube. This indicates that a suspension is unstable and shows settlement of heavier particles. For the preparation of a suspension of chalk in water, add 10 grams of fine chalk powder in a 250 ml beaker containing 95 ml distilled water. Then stir the solution using a glass rod. To check the transparency of chalk solution, take some of the chalk suspension in a test tube. Paste a small strip of cellophane paper on one side of the test tube and view it from the other side. The cellophane paper is not visible from the other side of the test tube. This indicates that the suspension is opaque. Filtration of chalk solution. Place a funnel over a test tube using a clamp stand. Then place a filter paper in the funnel. Now, pour the chalk suspension taken in another test tube through the funnel. A clear filtrate is obtained. Chalk particles are seen on the filter paper. This indicates that suspended components of a suspension can be separated by filtration. To check the stability of chalk solution, take some chalk suspension in a test tube and leave it in the test tube rack for 20 minutes. You will note a gradual settlement of soil particles at the bottom of the test tube. This indicates that a suspension is unstable and shows settlement of heavier particles. For the preparation of a suspension of fine sand in water, add 10 grams of fine sand in a 250 ml beaker containing 95 ml distilled water. Then stir the solution using a glass rod. To check the transparency of sand solution, take some of the sand suspension in a test tube. Paste a small strip of cellophane paper on one side of the test tube and view it from the other side. The cellophane paper is not visible from the other side of the test tube. This indicates that the suspension is opaque. Filtration of sand solution. Place a funnel over a test tube using a clamp stand. Then place a filter in the paper funnel. Now pour the sand suspension taken in another test tube through the funnel. A clear filtrate is obtained. Sand particles are seen on the filter paper. This indicates that suspended components of a suspension can be separated by filtration. To check the stability of sand solution, take some sand suspension in a test tube and leave it in the test tube rack for 20 minutes. You will note a gradual settlement of soil particles at the bottom of the test tube. This indicates that a suspension is unstable and shows settlement of heavier particles. Colloids. For the preparation of a colloidal of starch and water, take 1 gram of starch powder in a 250 ml beaker. From another beaker containing 100 ml distilled water, take 3 ml of water into a measuring jar and pour this into the beaker containing starch. Mix the solution well using a glass rod. Heat the beaker containing the remaining 97 ml of distilled water over a Bunsen burner. Pour the boiling water into the beaker containing starch. Stir it well using a glass rod and then cool it. To check the transparency of starch solution, take some of the colloidal of starch in a test tube. Paste a small strip of cellophane paper on one side of the test tube and view it from the other side. The cellophane paper can be seen vaguely from the other side of the test tube. This indicates that a colloid is translucent. Filtration of starch solution. Place a funnel over a test tube using a clamp stand. Then place a filter paper in the funnel. Now, pour the colloidal of starch taken in another test tube through the funnel. A translucent filtrate is obtained. No residue is left on the filter paper. This indicates that components causing colloid cannot be separated by filtration. To check the stability of starch solution, take some colloidal solution of starch in a test tube and leave it in the test tube rack for 20 minutes. No change is observed. This indicates that colloids are stable. Their solute particles do not settle down even after the lapse of time. For the preparation of a colloidal of egg albumin in water, take 1 gram of egg albumin in a 250 ml beaker. From another beaker containing 100 ml distilled water, take 5 ml of water into a measuring jar and pour this into the beaker containing egg albumin. Mix the solution well using a glass rod. Take the beaker containing the remaining 95 ml of distilled water and pour it slowly into the beaker containing egg albumin. Stir it well using a glass rod. A clear solution is obtained. Add a few drops of dilute HCl into this clear solution and stir it well. The clear solution of albumin and water will become turbid. To check the transparency of egg albumin solution, take some colloidal of egg albumin in a test tube. Paste a small strip of cellophane paper on one side of the test tube and view it from the other side. The cellophane paper can be seen vaguely from the other side of the test tube. This indicates that a colloid is translucent. Filtration of egg albumin solution. Place a funnel over a test tube using a clamp stand. Then place a filter paper in the funnel. Now, Pour the colloidal of egg albumin taken in another test tube through the funnel. A translucent filtrate is obtained. No residue is left on the filter paper. This indicates that components causing colloid cannot be separated by filtration. To check on the stability of egg albumin solution, take some colloidal solution of egg albumin in a test tube and leave it in the test tube rack for 20 minutes. No change is observed. This indicates that colloids are stable. Their solute particles do not settle down even after the lapse of time.